all this, my dear friend, there is hope for you. Whatever you are going through, whether sickness, whether pain, whether trouble, whether depression, whether financial crisis, whether marital problems, there is healing for you in Christ Jesus.
Viewers, you are welcome. Good evening. You are welcome to another edition of Healing the Hurting, Fulfilling God's Purpose, Glorifying God. We are very grateful that you are joining in today's episode and telecast. We are very grateful and we pray that God will bless you and will reward your time in the name of Jesus. I want to encourage you to call some of your friends and relations to join you to watch this episode of today. You will be mightily blessed in Jesus' name. We have in the house today a wonderful anointed man of God and somebody who loves the Lord so deeply, and he loves children, he loves families, he loves people coming from the ground and rising up to become great in life. And God has been using him in this area for quite a long time, and we are so blessed to have him in the house today. He's a very humble man by God's grace, and servant of the living God, son of Most High God, and is here today. Will be mightily blessed by his ministry and by his life in Jesus. So sit back and enjoy today's telecast. We'll just go on a short break. When we'll come back, you'll get to meet our guest, pass one on one, and then we'll continue with today's interview. God bless you. You are welcome back, sir. You are welcome to today's telecast, and this is Healing the Hurting, Fulfilling God's Purpose. The aim is to glorify God in people's lives as God meets their needs through us. Sir, I would like the viewers, our viewers, to meet you. Who is Pastor Odeyemi?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Pastor, my name is Pastor Emmanuel Oluneye Odeyemi. And I hail from a town that is known as the City of Rock. It is Abeokuta, a native of Abeokuta, in Nigeria, and a child of God.
So, what are you into, sir?
Well, I'm into children ministry, a child evangelist, and a pastor, a full pastor in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And by the special grace of God, I happen to be the head of department for the Directorate of Teens and Children Education in the Redeemed Christian Church of God.
Viewers, you have heard from the horse's mouth. Father and the Lord who is seated here today is Pastor E.O. Odeyemi. We thank God for his life. I'm sure you're going to be blessed by him being with us today. Now, sir,
yes, sir.
The issue we are discussing today has to do with children. And children related matters. We'll be looking at parents, we'll be looking at children. We know that there are children that are hurting. Hurting because of the kind of home they come from, hurting because of circumstances surrounding them, hurting because of the experiences that they are going through in the society. Some are going through rape. Some are going through abuse of all sorts. Some are going through spiritual attacks. Some children have become rebellious because it's a reaction to the circumstances or to the situations in their life or around them. Some are rebelling against the society because they feel that society has failed them. Some are victims of other children's rebellion. They are not the ones rebelling, but they are victims of other children that are become rebellious because of reaction to situations that they are going through or that they find themselves, they have found themselves in. Now, some parents are hurting also because of children that are incarcerated, children that are rebellious, children that are disobedient, children that are just problematic. Now, as a father, as a child minister, I know you don't only minister to children, you also minister to their parents.
Yes, sir.
By the reason of children. That's why we are here today. And then with your experience in the children ministry, you see them, you know them, you know what they're going through, you see things going on, you have a lot of words, you have seen things that you want to address, you want us to look into. So these are all the issues we'll look at in this episode, the next episode, and also in the third episode. So, starting from the beginning, what are your experiences with children? And what are the things that you have noticed in the children of today and of yesterday?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Children can be very wonderful because the Bible confirms that they are God's heritage. In Psalm 127. And don't forget that all human beings are image of God. Be it young or old. And when God created human beings, the Bible confirms that everything God created was good and wonderful. So I say, all children are wonderfully made and carefully made. Now, the reason why we are having all this problem among the children, I noticed that some children are having this problem because of the family background. Some are from polygamous house. Some are single parent. Children, the mother is nowhere, left the father and somebody else that's taking care of the child, and that some of the problem is as a result of the government themselves. Because in the olden days we discovered that one of the major curriculum, one of the major subjects that is taught right from primary school is religious knowledge. But nowadays, during our own days, in
the removal of religious knowledge.
When we gather in the school in those days, the first thing is to gather together, pray. Somebody will admonish us in the word of God, despite the fact that as that teacher is teaching, some people are pinching one another, some are slapping the other from the back. But yet, we look forward to another day when we gather together and hear the word of God. Many of the children, we take it very serious. And there are many, they just make it a day to while away and to cheat and to beat and to. But as time goes on, you discover that the word of God is being ministered to all of us early in the morning school. Not minding different background. Some of us are Muslim, some parents are Antichrist, some don't even believe in anything. Some will say there is no God. But in school, We come together and the word of God is being taught. And as a another aspect is as a result of anyway when you come to the other end of parents, I'll be able to expatiate on that. Most of the problem is parents not really handling their children the way they should handle them. Because most of the parents thought all they need to do is to give their children good education. And good education without moral training will amount to nothing. And the child will not be useful even to himself. Because by the time he goes out of the house, because there's no way you can keep your child in your home all the time. The stage will come when you have to go to school, higher institution, go to work, and whatsoever you keep that child with while he's under your roof, so whatsoever, that is exactly what he will become. Because the word of God says, train a child the way you go when he's old.
You will not depart from it.
That is Proverbs 22, verse 6. So in a nutshell, I discovered that the problems are one of the, as a result of the children themselves, the parents not doing what they should do at the right time, the society itself that is corrupt, and at the same time, the government.
Viewers, in today's episode, I don't know what you are going through. Maybe you have some children that are giving you pain. They already have become a pain in your neck. And you are disturbed, you are worried, you have done everything possible to bring these children under control. I believe as you watch today, the Lord will minister to your needs in Jesus' name. And he will wipe away your tears concerning those children.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And if you're a child and you have been wounded, you are hurting because you have been abandoned, you have not experienced parental care and love, you have been abused, you have been rejected, you have even been betrayed by parents or relations, or you feel lonely, you feel abandoned as if you are lonely, you have no friend, no father, no mother, you are an orphan. As you watch this program today, the Lord will minister to your heart. And he will show you the way out to a good life. In the name of Jesus. So, there is a scripture I want us to look at. But that will not distract you from your mind. That's Genesis chapter 4, from verse 1 to 14. Is about the story of Cain and Abel, the sons of Adam
and Eve.
Where did Cain get that mind from? What happened to Cain? Is it that they were not properly brought up? Or what happened? What led to the fact that, because in some homes, children don't see themselves face to face, eye to eye. They don't agree. There's some families that the children are so divided, those so disunited, the homes, the children are full of hatred to themselves. I mean, for one another, they hate themselves, they are rivals, they fight themselves. There's no love lost. And they're children from the same father, from the same mother. Cain and Abel, that's a good example. What was the problem? What could have led to Cain killing his brother? Where did he get the spirit of murder from? Because he became perhaps the first murderer. And that's just one. When you look also at 2 Samuel chapter 12, 1 to 33, we'll find the story of Ammon and the story of Absalom and the story of their sister. What happened to, where did Ammon got it from? Apart from somebody counseling him, that somebody advised him he should do this, but at the same time, the issue of incest. Many homes have been shattered. Many children's lives have been destroyed because of incest. That's another kind of problem among children, in families, in homes. Now, incest was not only committed, he now went on to become so, he became so wicked that he maltreated his own sister to the point that it was so terrible.
Yes, sir. I'm hearing you.
And then we also have the problem of, Absalom now killing the other boy. And then the last case is the case of Absalom who overthrew his father. And then he not only overthrew the father, then he went and slept with his father's wives. Then you also have the case of Eli and his sons who are sleeping with the ladies, the girls that were coming to the church. And then taking from the things of God. Now that's not just addressing the pastor's children, that's not the issue. The issue is that these children, it could have been, it doesn't have to be the church. It could have been those who are coming to do contract, to buy things at the shop. They were messing around with them, so it could have been anything. But these children were wayward, these children were weak, these children were loose, these children were mean. So what are these issues? Because I know there are children hurting, there are parents hurting, and I want to just give you the next few minutes to speak.
Praise the Lord. In the case of Cain and Abel, I want you to realize that they are the first of Adam and Eve, firstborn and secondborn. And after that, there is no other human being. So that there is no way we can say it is friends that influence them or peer group or this and that. It's only Cain and Abel. The only thing, what happens in their own case is that, you know, it's a matter of sacrificing, making a sacrifice unto God. This one brought the best, this one brought the other one. God accepted one, God rejected one, and so on and so forth. I want you to know that their parents have already told them that when you want to sacrifice unto God, you take the best. They know that. That is not the first time Cain and Abel will make a sacrifice unto God. They've been taught how to make sacrifice. They've been taught to the fear of God. They've been taught that sacrifice goes to God. They've been taught the reason why they make sacrifice is a result of maybe you've sinned and then that God will take that as thank God for Jesus Christ who has now came to sacrifice himself for us, and by the blood of Jesus all sins are forgiven. But what really happens is that the mind of man is full of evil.
Desperately wicked.
And the book of Psalms, it says that children or human beings, even from the womb, have decided to either be good or bad. And that is the reason why you see a child, nobody will teach his child that when I'm not at home, you can steal. or when I'm not at home and you went out to play football, to play with your friends, as soon as I come in, you can lie. No mother will tell a child like that, that when your father comes, you lie to him that you are at home, all out. But we discovered that even while we were all young, we tell little lies. And this is as a result of that word of God that says, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And that a man that is born of a woman are sinners. Because on that day that the devil came to the garden to deceive them, a man was caused by God. We discovered that as from that day, we know evil and bad.
The cause. As from the cause.
And that is the reason why in Deuteronomy chapter 6, from verses 1 to 10, God instructed them that this you must teach yourself, and at the same time verses emphasize that you must teach your children. He even went further to discuss, to tell them how, place the word of God on the wall, sit them down, do this, do that, telling them that you have to use visual aids when need be, posters, signboards, and so on, so that they don't forget. Because he knew quite well that inside the children, inside human beings, young and old, are evil and crude. So that is the reason why you see in that story, one decided that if God will not take my offering and God accepted your own, the best thing for me to kill you.
Envy.
And despite that, God still showed mercy on him. Put a mark on him and so that nobody will kill him. So the good news I have for all parents that are hurt is that it's not yet too late.
Amen.
It's never too late.
Amen.
The moment you apply, when you come to the other end, the mathematician, we call it a theory or a formula. That's a formula by which parents should apply. Whatsoever is the age of that child, you can still bring him back.
Amen.
Correct him. Molding. It is true, some adage says, when the fish is dry, if you try to mold, it will crack. But these are not dried fish, they are human beings. The something that of God is still in them. For the simple fact that they are still breathing, they still have that which is of God. And God is ready. If God can touch Saul of Tarsus on his way to Damascus, and change him to Paul, there's nobody God cannot change.
Amen.
So the good news I have to them is that by the time they apply this, the correct rule, they will discover that God will take control. And those parents those children that they feel cannot change, they will change to good.
Amen.
And at their old age, they will be source of joy to them.
Amen. 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 Viewers, we're just taking this as an intro into our discussion on children. And we are just starting today. By next week, we'll go deeper and deeper and deeper. But we have been given a word of hope that it's never too late and that our children can still change. Never give up on that child. Never give up on that child. If I can sit here today, then there is no child that cannot be changed. Never give up on that child. God can bring your child back to God. You might have been weeping, might have been crying, might have been praying, and the more you pray, it's as if the deeper the child is going, and you wonder whether God is up there still hearing, and he's still there up there. God is still there. He's watching. He's walking already behind the scene for you. He's doing something to bring that child back to God. That child will serve the Lord. Your children or your child is an heritage of God, and he will follow the ways of the Lord. He will live for God. He will give you joy. He will give you peace.
Amen.
Or she will give you delight.
Amen.
And you will glorify God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every child of pain will become a child of joy.
Amen.
Will become a child of gain.
Amen.
You will make good profit from your children in the name of children. And Jesus. And for you children that are also going through pain, maybe you have once felt rejected. You have once felt you've disappointed God. You don't need to kill anybody. You don't need to be envious of anybody. God can give you another chance to improve on yourself and do better. All you need to do is to open up to God today. And if you are here today, you are laboring under a curse, and it is the curses that brought all this problem, then you can be free from the curses, because Jesus died on the cross to take away the curses from us. And you can live a curseless life. So we'll be closing today. And I want the man of God, our guest in today's telecast, Pastor E.O. Odeyemi, to pray for us. He'll be ministering to children who feel that they are laboring under curses. They are doing things they don't understand why they are doing it, and they are misbehaving. Some terrible behaviors are in your hand. You find yourself full of hatred, full of bitterness, full of anger, full of envy, full of all kinds of spirits. As he prays for you, there will be deliverance for you, and you shall receive freedom. And please don't miss next episode. Get all your friends to watch next episode, because we are going deeper and deeper and deeper. You and they will experience the grace of God in your lives, just as we have experienced before, in Jesus' mighty name. So we'd like you to, maybe any last word before we pray? For children or anybody?
Children all over the world, I want you to know that you are an image of God. And like father, like son, take God as your father. Try as much as possible to be with him. Try as much as possible to give your life to him. And you discover that God will change you for better.
Amen.
And to parents over there, as I said, don't give up. Don't give up. Just have the faith that God, who owns all children, will touch your child and turn him to. Be a good child that will give you joy all the days of your life.
Amen.
So I want us to pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you because you are the Almighty God.
Thank you, Father.
I just want to remind you of your word that says, whoever come unto you, we never cast away.
Amen.
If you're ever there and you are saying, when will this church change? I want you to mention the name of your child and say to God, today I realize they are your heritage, and it's never too late. Change this, my boy. Change this, my dad.
Amen.
And as you say that, the Almighty God will touch that child.
Amen.
And change him for better.
Amen. Should you decide to give your life to Christ, I want to encourage you to say this prayer after us this moment. Say, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I repent of my sins. I receive Jesus into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. I confess of my wicked ways. I surrender to you totally. Come into my heart and reign in my heart, Lord Jesus, forever. Thank you for saving me. I write my name, Lord, please write my name in the book of life of the Lamb of God. And rapture me with all the saints of God in the name of Jesus. I love you, Father. Thank you for forgiving me. Use me for your own glory and keep me to the end. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Congratulations. Just as you have decided today, I believe that God has other prayers. And peace and joy will return back to your home and to your life. In the name of Jesus. I want to encourage you to join us at the monthly Holy Ghost services that is being held at kilometer 46 Lagos Ibadan Expressway, and ministering is our Father and the Lord, my daddy, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. He ministers every first Friday of every month. Also, every first Monday and of the month, he also takes on Divine Encounter and Shiloh Hour for those who are trusting for the fruit of the womb, and Divine Encounter for those who believe God, believing God for breakthrough in their endeavors. Please join in those programs. If you cannot come because of distance, you are far away, I want to encourage you to log on to www.rccg.org. Then you key into the Holy Ghost Service program there. You'll be able to watch it live on such days, 7 p.m. Nigerian time. Or log on to Holy Ghost Service, Holy Ghost TV, Holy Ghost Service TV. Then you'll be able to watch that program. The Lord bless you. Have a wonderful day. The Lord will increase you. The Lord will perfect all that concerns you. He will fill your mouth with laughter. By the time we watch next week, I'm sure you have a testimony to give concerning your family, your parents, or your children in the name of Jesus. Stay blessed and stay rapturable. See you same time next week on Healing the Hurting, Fulfilling God's Purpose, Glorifying God. Thank you for watching, and God bless you.